Hello, welcome to another video of Thermodynamics 2 class. In this video, I'm going to explain the activity number three of the lecture guide 20. So if you share the, let's just share the screen. You'll see, let's see, let's share the correct one. Share the screen, step two, share it, okay, yes. So the activity three describes a cooling and humidification, dehumidification process. Air enters a window air conditioner at 100 kPa, 30 degrees Celsius at 80% relative humidity at a rate of 10 cubic meters per minute and leaves as saturated air at 14 degrees Celsius. Part of the moisture in the air that condenses during the process is also removed at 14 degrees Celsius. Determine the rate of heat and moisture removal from the air. Okay, so its process takes place at the same place, same time, cooling and the humidification. You can see the diagram. This is the pretty similar thing that you did in the air conditioning laboratory class. So air comes at 30 degrees Celsius and 80% relative humidity as it is shown in this diagram. And at T2 is 14 degrees Celsius and V2 is 100%. And this is the condensate removal from at the same temperature as in the exit temperature, 14 degrees Celsius saturated liquid temperature. So in this case, we have to consider the psychometric chart. You at 30 degrees Celsius and 80% relative humidity, you mark the first location. And then you cool it down until you hit the saturation, right? You hit the saturation, and then it goes through the saturation line. It stays at the 100% specific humidity, sort of relative humidity all the time until it reaches the 14 degree Celsius temperature. So that's the state one and two. If you want to calculate the amount of heat transfer during the process, you can find H2 and H1. In this case, and also if you wanted to find the amount of removal of water vapor, you can find it by calculating the change between omega 1 and omega 2. So let's see how we're going to do that by using an actual psychometric chart. So now I'm going to share my other screen, zoom. Share the screen, share it, okay. And now this is the previous diagram. I'm going to erase these things quickly. Let's set it up for the next one. Right. So it says 30 degree and 80% relative humidity. So let's mark that one. 30 degree here goes along this line, 30 degree relative until 30 degrees Celsius until 80% relative humidity right there. So this is the state point. And if you want to find the specific humidity, you can draw a parallel line you these. It's just pretty close to 22. You can say it's 22. And then also, if you want to find the enthalpy, you draw a parallel line to these lines. Which is equal to 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, close to 86. Close to 86, so write 86 in here, right? So this is my state one. And then it cools down. So without changing any without changing any humidity, specific humidity, sit down to here, and then it comes along the 100% specific humidity line, 100% relative humidity line, until hits the, this is 15 degrees Celsius right here, and 14 is right there. So that's my state two, where you have 100% relative humidity because you have condensate releasing. And now we can draw lines for the enthalpy. So we have this line, it's pretty close to 40, let's say it's 40. Need a bit 40, and then you need a specific humidity here, so that's along this line is 10, so I say it is 10, and then enthalpy and specific humidity is found. Yeah, so and also at state one, you are given the mass per rate, sort of volume for it, so you may need to convert the into mass per rate. So you need the specific volume. So a specific volume is, this is 0.88, this is 0.89. So let's say this is pretty close to 0.89. Right, this is right here. It's 0.889, then, right, 0.889. So we can have this value. So this is gonna be 0.889 cubic meters per kilogram of dry air, right? 0.889 cubic meters of kilogram of dry air. So now we have all the information that necessary for the that are necessary for the calculation. So let's go back to our whiteboard, new page, and we have all the data. So we're going to show, that process in the diagram where it is shown according to that figure. Figure three in your lecture note, we have this. So Q evaporator, that's the heat removed from the system, but we don't know what it is. So we write the evaporator minus W dot evaporator, which is zero. This is zero, plus M dot A, H1 minus H2 equals zero. So this is zero, and then you have E dot evaporator, M dot A times H2 minus H1. So you're going to end up with the negative value. So M dot A is equal to V dot 1 divided by V1, right? Specific volume. That's going to be, this is 10 divided by 60 cubic meters per second, because V dot 1 is 10 cubic meters per minute, right? So I converted that to cubic meter seconds, divided by that 0.889. We found that from the psychometric chart. Cubic meters per kilogram of dry air. So that results as 8.89 divided by 60. So this is 0.89 divided by 60. Let's see. 0.148 kilogram of dry air. A second. That one. And then you have H2 from the psychometric chart. We had 40, and H1 is 86. So we have H, this is going to be M dot A, 0.148. This is 40 minus 86. That'll give you the total heat value, whatever the answer for this one. And the second question, what is the other question? I determine the rate of heat and moisture removal. So moisture removal can be found by amount of moisture removal. Is equal to M dot A times omega 1 minus omega 2. So we can find omega 1. We found it from our diagram 22, and omega 2 is 10. So we're going to have, this is 0.148 times omega 1 is 22 minus 6, check it out, 10, I'm sorry. This is 10 grams. So this is actually, this units of 0.148 is kilogram of dry air per second, and then this is 22 minus 10 grams per kilogram of dry air. Okay, so this cancel out that, and then you can get grams per second, this answer. But you can convert that into kilograms per second over this. But that's the amount of moisture removal. So with the involvement of psychometric chart, it's pretty easy. So the only thing is that you get to learn how you're gonna read the psychometric chart for in different situations. Yeah, thank you for watching this video. See you in another video for some other activity.